So, hi guys, I'm Lucrecia and I'm a student in the, I'm a student in the ecology and evolutionary biology program here at Rice. And I love big cat species, and this is why I spent last summer and the rest of this year studying jaguars and looking at the effect of what we call selective logging, which is different than clear cutting, on these jaguars in Belize. So jaguars are declining throughout their range. As you can see from this map, they've actually lost 54% of their historic habitat. And jaguars are really important because they're what we call keystone species. And this means that when you take them out of the ecosystem because they go extinct, the whole ecosystem starts to fall apart. And this has really bad effects for other species and for humans in the area as well. But one of the issues for jaguars is that there just isn't enough protected land to conserve them long term. And so one of the things we need to know is how can we use land so that it's good for jaguars and good for people? So how can we have multi-use landscapes? And this was my main question. So I wanted to know that how does timber logging affect jaguar habitat use in these multi-use landscapes? So timber logging is good for humans because there's an economic component, but maybe if it's done well, it could be good for jaguars too because it conserves some land. So to do this, I traveled to Belize last summer and did field work, which included moments like this where we got cars stuck for 6 hours. And what we were doing is we were setting up what are called camera traps. And this is an example of a camera trap right here. And what it does is you put it up on trees throughout the forest, and it captures images of animals that walk past it. So it's motion sensored. So we can get images of these species even though we're not there. And that's really important for things like jaguars because they're really elusive and they won't come out when people are around. So we put these cameras up, we got these pictures, and then I analyzed the image depth to look at how many jaguars there were in different places, so in different places where we put the cameras. And I compared how many jaguars there were to these four different factors: logging, rivers, villages and farmland, and roads. And what I wanted to know is, do these factors influence how many jaguars we are seeing? And what I found is that logging, rivers, and villages and farmland do seem to impact how many jaguars we are seeing in a negative way. So the closer you are to these three things, the fewer jaguars we're catching on camera. But roads, it was actually the opposite. It seems like jaguars actually really like to use roads because they're kind of lazy and it's a lot easier than walking through the forest. So what this all means is that it is possible for jaguars to exist in a multi-use landscape, but it has to be really well managed. So for example, if you put selective logging areas that jaguars are avoiding in key jaguar habitat, that's going to be a problem because jaguars are going to avoid that area. And this is really important for conservation on a broader scale because jaguars are threatened, like I mentioned before, and they are declining. And this has huge ramifications for both people and other species in this area because ecosystems fall apart, ecotourism industries fall apart, and it has a really big impact on cultures as well. In some cultures, jaguars represent deities in creation stories, and so losing them could be like losing a huge part of what makes your culture and what makes you you. So overall, I'm really hoping that this research helps us to conserve jaguars and conserve our natural world on a broader scale. Thank you.